प्रिय विद्यार्थियों, आज हम स्टडी करेंगे बीए पार्ट सेकंड के सेकंड पेपर में प्रेस्क्राइब्ड स्टोरी ए रोज फॉर एमिली, शॉर्ट स्टोरी बाय विलियम फॉकनर। विलियम फॉकनर 1897 to 1962 an American novelist and short story writer, was born in Mississippi, where his family had settled long back. He spent most of his life there, in the towns of Oxford. He hailed from an aristocratic southern family, and the history and legends of the South, of his own family, were material for most of his books. After a desultory education and working at various odd jobs, he met S. Anderson while working as a journalist in New Orleans, who encouraged him to write his first novel, Soldier's Pay, in 1926. Most of his novels and stories are set in Jefferson, a complete picture of several Mississippi towns in the mythical Yoknapatawpha country created by Faulkner. He was awarded the Nobel Prize in 1949. His other important works include Absalom, a Fable, The Revivers, and several volumes of short stories collected in 1950s. So this was the introduction of the author William Faulkner. Now we will discuss the story, A Rose for Emily. A Rose for Emily is a short story by American author William Faulkner, first published on 1930s in an issue of the Forum. The story takes place in Faulkner's fictional city, Jefferson, Mississippi, in the southern country of Yoknapatawpha. It was Faulkner's first short story published in a national magazine. First, we will discuss the title of the story, A Rose for Emily. Faulkner described the title, A Rose for Emily, as an allegorical title. This woman had undergone a great tragedy, and for this Faulkner pitied her. As a salute, he handed her a rose. The word rose in the title has multiple meanings to it. The rose may be seen as Homer when interpreting the rose as a dried rose. Homer's body could be the dried rose, such as one that is pressed between the pages of a book, kept in a perfect condition, as Emily did with Homer's body. The rose also represents secrecy. Roses have been portrayed in Greek legends as a gift of secrecy and of confidentiality, known as saprosa, implying that the rose is a symbol of silence between the narrator and Miss Emily, whose secrets the narrator keeps until her death. The story opens with a first-person account of the funeral of Emily Grissom. Now we will discuss the summary of the story, A Rose for Emily. So the story opens with a first-person account of the funeral of Emily Grissom, an elderly southern woman whose funeral is an obligation of their small town. It then proceeds in a non-linear fashion to be the narrator's recollections of Emily's archaic and increasingly strange behavior throughout the years. Emily is a member of a family of the antebellum southern aristocracy. After the Civil War, the family falls into the hard times. She and her father, the last two of the clan, continues to live as if in the past. Emily's father refuses for her to marry. Her father dies when Emily is about the age of 30, which takes her by surprise. She refuses to give up his corpse, and the townspeople write it off as her grieving process. The townspeople pity Emily not only after her father's death, but also during his life when he wouldn't let Emily marry. Emily depended heavily on her father, believing he would never leave her. He was all she had. After her father's death, the only person seen serving about Emily's home is Toby, a black man serving as Emily's butler. He is frequently seen entering and exiting the house for groceries. Though Emily did not have a strong relationship with her community, she did give her art lessons to young children with her town at the age of 40. A prime reason why she gave art lessons was her financial problem, since she was running out of money. The townspeople make cruel comments and nasty looks behind Miss Emily's back, as she wasn't respected in her town. With the acceptance of her father's death, Emily somewhat revives, even changing the style of her hair, and becomes friendly with Homer Barron. He is a northern laborer who comes to town shortly after Mr. Grissom's death. The connection surprises some of the community, while others are glad she is taking an interest. However, Homer's like man and claims that he is not a marrying man. This draws attention to Homer's questionable sexuality in the story. Emily shortly buys arsenic from a druggist in town, presumably to kill rats. However, The town's people are convinced that she will use it to poison herself. Emily's distant cousins are called into town by minister's wife to supervise Miss Emily and Homer Barron. Homer leaves town for some time, reputedly to give Emily a chance to get rid of her cousin, and returns 3 days later after the cousins have left. After he is observed entering Miss Emily's home one evening, Homer is never seen alive again. Despite this turbulence in her social status, Emily continues to behave mysteriously, as she had not before her father died. Her reputation is such that the city council finds itself unable to confront her about a strong smell that she has begun to emanate from the house. They believed Toby was unable to maintain the house and something was rotting, unaware that a death has occurred. Instead, the council decides to send men to her house under the cover of darkness to sprinkle lime around the house, after which the smell dissipates. The mayor of the town, Connell, makes a gentleman agreement to overlook her taxes as an act of charity, though it is done under a pretense of repayment towards her father. To assure Emily's pride after her father's death, years later, when the next generation has come to power, Emily insists on his informal arrangement, flatly refusing that she owes any taxes, stating, "I have no taxes in Jefferson." After this, the council reclines to press the issue due to her stubbornness. Emily has become a recluse. She has never been outside of the house and only rarely accepts people into it. The community eventually comes to view her as a hereditary obligation on the town, who must be humored and tolerated. The funeral is a large affair. Emily had become an institution, so her death sparks a great deal of curiosity after her recursive nature and what remains of her house. After she is buried, a group of townsfolk enters her house to see what remains of her life there. Toby walked out of the house and was never seen again, giving the townspeople access to Miss Emily's home. The door to her upstairs bedroom is locked, and some of the townsfolk break down the door to see what was hidden for so long. Inside, among the possessions that Emily had brought for Homer, lies the decomposed corpse of Homer Barron on the bed. On the pillow beside him is the indignation of a head and a single strand of gray hair, indicating that Emily had slept with Homer's corpse. The house is an indicator revealing how Emily struggled to keep everything the same in a frozen time period, avoiding change. So, this was the summary of the story, A Rose for Emily.